Yes, I'm Rod Pidskalny. I'm the operations manager here at Spruce Products. I've been involved with the company since 2005. So here in the sawmill, we've got 90 plus employees that are directly employed by Spruce Products. And that's employees that are working on site in our different operations, plus our employees that are involved in our kind of bush operations as well. So a large group, a major employer, I guess, within the valley here. Well, the raw material that we source our kind of products from basically is spruce and jack pine, white spruce and black spruce and jack pine. And it's locally sourced within the region. The products that we produce here at Spruce Products are dimensional lumber from anything from a 1x4 6 foot is our kind of smallest and shortest length, all the way up to a 2x10 16 foot. So the customers that Spruce Products supplies lumber to are located generally within a kind of a closer kind of geographic area. We sell a lot into Manitoba, southern Manitoba, Saskatchewan, northwest Ontario, and a little bit into southern Ontario. One of the things that we were kind of talking about when we first initially started to talk about kilns is that we were kind of looking at maybe moving away from a traditional batch type kiln to the new CDK process, going to a different kind of a drying process to have a little bit better quality, maybe a little bit gentler and a little bit kind of a quicker process. So we looked at a couple of different suppliers and we actually traveled to a couple of different locations to see how a new kind of design CDK would operate. In our initial kind of investigation into the CDKs, we just happened to see, I think, I'm not exactly sure how we even found out about ValueTech, whether it was just in a magazine ad, I think that's what it was, or on a kind of a website, or maybe a kind of an ad for a kind of an expo somewhere, where we saw this kind of new type kiln design that looked like it was a blend of a kind of a CDK and a kind of a batch kiln. But one of the main things that really intrigued us quite a bit was that there was doors on the end and it was a continuous type kiln process. It wasn't a batch kiln. It was a continuous kiln, but it had doors on the end to keep the heat in. So one of the things we discovered in our kind of travels doing the research with the CDKs was that the ends were open, and in the winter time there was a lot of heat and a lot of steam and a lot of moisture kind of coming out the ends of the doors and a lot of ice buildup essentially. And that for us looked like it was going to be a big problem in our environment because we've got winter frozen conditions from November well into March. We did what was called a supervisor build. We had a couple of supervisors that came from Sweden and kind of oversee the project where we supplied our own contracting crew. With regards to the startup and the commissioning, we had a couple of individuals come from Sweden to help us with the startup and the commissioning. And essentially it was, we started putting lumber in there on Thursday and we were planing it on Monday is how it actually worked. And it worked exactly as everybody said it was going to go.
I'm Marty Fullerton. I work at Spruce Products. I'm chief engineer here and I look after the dry kilns as well. My first impressions of the kiln were the speed that it dries. And also the quality of the lumber coming out is very nice compared to our batch kilns. The kiln is very easy to use, very straightforward controls. Support's been really good. Startup went very smooth. The Valmonic system is pretty easy to work with. Didn't have much trouble getting used to it compared to our old system. Got a lot of help from you guys at ValueTech.
So far what we're seeing with the drying results is a drastic reduction in the warpage, which has created a higher grade lumber for us. We're seeing less economy grade. Our standard deviation has also gone way down, so we're seeing a much more even moisture content coming out of it. The moisture content in terms of sales is very important, especially when it comes to your narrow widths, 2x4. I've been able to gain some more customers that we haven't reached before, just because I've been pushing, we have a straighter product now.